chochote utataka nitakupa. Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. It's your girl Fanny Lungu back with another reaction video. If you're new to this channel, make sure to give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and of course do not forget to subscribe. Like I said, my name is Fanny Lungu, and on this channel we post reaction videos each and every day. So if there's something that you guys want us to react to, let us know and we'll be more than glad to do it for you. A big shout out to everyone that has subscribed to our channel so far. Thank you for subscribing, liking, commenting, sharing, everything that you guys do, including watching. We appreciate. I hope you guys are doing all right and may you stay blessed. A big shout out to the person that suggested this. Today we're going to be reacting to 10 prophets who made prophecies in Islam. So without wasting time, let's get into the video.
The Quran, a holy book that Muslims recite and turn to for guidance in all aspects of their life. The Quran contains a significant amount of prophecies that were made by many of the prophets throughout history. Hey everyone, how are you guys doing today? It's your boy Alan Luqman and welcome back to FTD Facts, where we're posting daily videos talking about the cool world that we live in. So Prophet Nuh was given the duty of preaching to his people. He would advise them to abandon idolatry and only worship God and to live a pure and good life. So Prophet Nuh warned his people that a great flood would come and wipe those who keep continuing to commit sin. In order to stay alive, they needed to build an ark. So while Prophet Nuh was preaching, only a few people decided to pay attention to what the prophet had to say and joined him in building the ark. And the rest of the nation, including his own son, were wiped away with the great flood. So on number 9, we have Prophet Hud, who was an ancient Arabic prophet who preached to the people of Ad. So many of the people he preached refused to pay attention to his teachings and they kept ignoring and mocking what he was preaching. And those people that kept mocking him continued to take part in idolatry. And the reason why idolatry is a sin in Islam, because it is considered to be wrong for somebody to worship something or someone other than God as if they were God. So after many warnings by the prophet, it is believed that God sent a thunderstorm strong enough to wipe out all the sinful people of Ad. So on number 8, we have Prophet Suleiman. So there was this nation, nation of Saba, which was a rich and powerful country that worshipped the sun. So Prophet Suleiman sent a messenger to the queen and asked her and her nation to become Muslim. So during this meeting, the queen acknowledged that he was a real prophet and she accepted his rulings. So however, the powerful nation of Saba, with wealth and welfare, eventually gave up on worshipping Allah, even though they were warned by the prophet to worship Allah and nothing else. He would warn them by telling them that they would be punished just like the previous nations. Soon, they were punished by a big flood, their fertile land was transformed into an arid land, and their country started to become really poor. So on number 7, we have Prophet Saleh. Prophet Saleh is a prophet mentioned in the Quran who prophesies to the tribe of Thamud. He was chosen by God to preach against selfishness of the wealthy and to stop practicing idolatry. So the people of Thamud refused to hear his warnings and began to ask Saleh to perform a miracle. So in response to that, God gave the people of Thamud a blessed she-camel, which is a miraculous female camel which is also mentioned in the Quran. So Saleh told the tribe to avoid harming the camel and to let her eat grass peacefully. So despite the warning, people decided to cripple the camel and then they were warned that they only have 3 days to live. And in 3 days, a huge earthquake killed all of the disbelieving people in the city. Saleh himself and a few believers who followed him survived. So on number 6, we have Prophet Shoaib. So Shoaib was a prophet who was appointed to the people of Midian. So the people of this land were really prone to cheating others through dishonesty and took part in idolatry. He would tell his people to stop being dishonest in their daily activities and also warn the people that their ignorance would lead to the destruction of Midian. He would give examples of earlier prophets such as Nuh and Hud and how the disbelievers before them were destroyed by God. So the Midianites still refused to believe and they were destroyed by a huge earthquake. But in the Quran, it is mentioned that Prophet Shoaib and his believing companions did survive. Hello guys, if you guys are enjoying this video so far, if you guys find it interesting, yo, please make sure to hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe. On number 5, we have Prophet Musa. So Prophet Musa, who's also known as Moses in Christianity, was sent to the Pharaoh of Egypt to guide him in worshiping one God and to free the Israelites. He also warned them that they would get punished for being disbelievers. But the Pharaoh was arrogant and defiant of Prophet Musa and did not accept Allah's message. So it is believed that God started punishing these people, and these punishments came in the form of floods that demolished their houses, swarms of locusts that would destroy their crops, and turning all the drinking water into blood. All these events became very humiliating for the Pharaoh. So when the Pharaoh tried chasing Prophet Musa and the escaped Israelites, Musa split the sea, which allowed the Israelites to pass through. But when the Pharaoh and his army tried passing through the split sea, the sea closed in on them. So number four, we have Prophet Ibrahim. So in the Quran, it is stated that the Prophet Ibrahim prayed to Allah to bless the descendants of both his children and to keep all of their descendants in the protection of God. This prophecy did come true because after his prayers were accepted, Allah gave many messengers to guide the people of his descendants. So Prophet Musa, Isa, and Muhammad, peace be upon him, are all descendants from Ibrahim's lineage. So on number three, we're going to be talking about Prophet Lot. So he was sent to preach to the twin cities of Sodom and Gomorrah. So in the Quran, it says that their sins included inhospitality and robbery. So they hated strangers and robbed travelers as well as other violent acts, but most importantly, they committed the sins of homosexual acts. So Prophet Lot prayed to the God and asked to be saved from the consequences of their sinful acts. So two angels ended up coming to earth and revealed themselves to Prophet Lot. So after these two angels revealed themselves, they told him that they were sent by God to bring down the folks of this town because of the sins they were committing. But him and his believing family members and those who believed in him left the city during the night. So the angels even told the prophet that his own wife would be left behind because of her sinful nature. So by the morning came, the whole city was turned upside down and rained stones on them. So on number two, we have Prophet Yusuf. So it is believed that the king of Egypt had a dream of seven fat cows being eaten by seven skinny ones and seven ears of corn being replaced by shriveled ones. So when he woke up to this dream, he was really terrified. Unfortunately, none of his advisors could interpret what the dream really meant. So there was this one servant who was released from prison and he heard about it. So he remembered how Prophet Yusuf from prison had interpreted his dreams, and he persuaded the king to send him to Yusuf so that he could return with an interpretation. So Prophet Yusuf told the servant that Egypt would face 7 years of prosperity and then suffer 7 years of famine, and that the king should prepare for it so he can avoid a great suffering. So in time, it is believed that Prophet Yusuf's interpretation and prophecy did come true, and the king had prepared well enough to endure the tough years of famine. So on number one, we have Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. So as Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, was on his deathbed, he is believed to have told his daughter that she would join him first after he passes away. So Fatima did end up being the first one in the family to pass away after the Holy Prophet, which was about 6 months right after he passed away. If you guys enjoyed the video, definitely make sure to hit the like button. Don't forget to subscribe and make sure to follow my social media, and you guys can ask me any question there. I'll see you guys next time. Peace.
I think most of us are aware of all these prophets, although I would love for you guys to help me out with the prophets at 6, 7 and 9. What are their names in English, or do they not have English names? For those ones, I just want to know if I know them or I don't. Otherwise, this was a great video. Let me know what you think and feel free to suggest anything that you want us to react to in the comments section below. And from this video, you can see that each prophet had their own message and each prophet was telling different prophecies and just trying to get people to keep their faith and believe in God. Otherwise, make sure to give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and of course, do not forget to subscribe, and I'll see you in my next reaction video.